Have you ever won anything major before?
No, never.
Well, you have now.
Oh, my God, I guess.
Yeah.
Are you kidding?
No, it's confirmed.
Are you sure?
Uh-huh.
Okay, what did I win?
Either the Chevy Blazer, the Paris...
Do you have a water filtration system in your house?
Was it called the filter?
Mm-hmm.
No, sir, pretty sure no.
Well, do you read the papers or watch TV? Well, then you've probably seen our advertisements.
Now, as I said, Irene, the government is going to make you pay a tax on the prize.
Oh.
But if you buy the Waterson 2000 water filtration system, the prize gets recorded as a sales expense, and you don't pay any tax.
Oh,
good deal, huh?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, and then I get the trip.
You're guaranteed one of those three prizes. I'm going to have a courier come to your house. You're going to give him a check. He's going to come to me. And then we'll decide which one of those prizes you get. Do you see how that works?
Well, how much do I pay?
$398 even.
Oh,
you pay twice that in stores.
I need to speak to my husband.
You want to what? Irene, my supervisor just stepped into my office, and he would love to talk to you. Can you hold just a sec?
Thanks, Irene.
Good morning.
Who says so?
Irene Fisk. She wants to talk to her husband first.
Mrs. Fisk.
Yes.
John Goodhue, Regional Vice President.
Oh.
Congratulations! Which prize are you hoping for?
Oh, Paris.
Well, that would be my choice, too.
We've never been.
My associate tells me you have 5 grandkids?
Was that like your strong finish or something?
Motherfucker!
What? You leave me no choice the way you play.
That's the 4th time you done played that bitch of spades on my ass.
No. Dowling over here had it 3 hands ago, and 2 hands ago I got the Black Mariah, so I don't want to hear you bitching, okay?
Yeah, but he shot the moon on that hand,
yeah,
didn't he?
Yeah, I saw that.
So it helped you.
Okay, you're right.
You ain't walking out of here with a grits worm.
You know the drill, okay? Come on, I'm not gonna smoke them. I'll hold on to them. If you want them back, you can trade me for them or try to play Double or Nothing tomorrow.
Murphy, what the hell are you sitting there for? You process. Come on.
Process? This motherfucker's getting a jump.
Come on, man. Have some decency here, worm. You can buy the smokes you want in a half an hour.
What the fuck are you talking about? I just won these fair and square.
You don't even smoke, worm.
Jesus. You guys are such fucking babies, you know that? If you're determined to die of cancer, you really ought to learn how to play cards.
Ain't a good idea to add insult to injury, yo. That shit'll come back and hurt you.
You know what? Not in this lifetime, Holmes. Enjoy your time.
Perfect.
Your Highness, please allow me to make this little contribution.
No, I cannot accept them.
But think of what these could do for your cause.
Even though I know those pearls would mean freedom for many of my people, I will not take them.
Please. Please. These could save the lives of many men.
The men of my country are proud. They would die rather than have their prince accept charity.
But then think of the lives of the women, the mothers, those who...
The women of my country fight alongside the men. They are also too proud to accept charity.
Then consider the lives of the children, the innocent children.
But for the children.
She can go to court and we can prove it was suicide.
Oh, can we? Mr. Norton, first thing that struck me was that suicide angle. Only I dumped it into the waste paper basket just 3 seconds later. You know, you ought to take a look at the statistics on suicide sometime. You might learn a little something about the insurance business.
Mr. Keyes, I was raised in the insurance business.
Yeah, in the front office. Come now, you've never read an actuarial table in your life, have you? Why, we've got 10 volumes on suicide alone. Suicide by race, by color, by occupation, by sex, by seasons of the year, by time of day. Suicide, how committed? By poisons, by firearms, by drowning, by leaps. Suicide by poison, subdivided by types of poison, such as corrosive, irritant, systemic, gaseous, narcotic, alkaloid, protein, and so forth. Suicide by leaps, subdivided by leaps from high places, under the wheels of trains, under the wheels of trucks, under the feet of horses, from steamboats. But Mr. Norton, of all the cases on record, there's not one single case of suicide by leap from the rear end of a moving train. And do you know how fast that train was going at the point where the body was found? 15 miles an hour. Now, how can anybody jump off a slow-moving train like that with any kind of expectation that he would kill himself? No, no soap, Mr. Norton. We're sunk, and we'll have to pay through the nose, and you know it. May I have this? Come on, Walter. Next time I'll rent a tuxedo.
Driver's name is Arthur Shea, former Medford police officer, 57 years old. As soon as his partner leaves with the coal bag, Artie cracks a Herald, and he don't look up till the guy gets back. Marty McGuire, Cummins Armored Courier, 5'10", 220, 52 years old. Picks up every Wednesday and Friday at exactly 8:12, makes $110 a day, carries a Sig 9. And he's about to get robbed. We're fucked if we see a helicopter, we're fucked if we see SWAT. We see a cruiser, stop, take out the engine blocks, keep moving. No one needs to get hurt.
Now, these guards like to test you, though. They want to get hurt for $10 an hour, don't get in the way.
Let's go.
Watch it.
Questions are here.
Like walking on the bottom of the sea, as if I had drowned long ago.
As 5 minutes, Mr. Barry.
Yeah, so where'd you put it?
Ready, Mr. Barry.
You ready, America?
Oh, thanks, Jim.
Right,
1 minute.
Move a little to your left.
Hey, video, you done with the test patterns?
Camera one.
Okay, clear the floor, folks.
Marty, you're still very hot.
Light it up, lighting.
Stand by.
Opening shots, please.
30 seconds. 30 seconds.
I'm getting a flare on camera one. You think you can adjust the barn door on Jack's backlight? Yeah, if you can.
20 seconds.
My light okay. My nose doesn't look big.
You look great, Jack.
This last week I look like a sundial.
Jack, we're on countdown.
Coming to air in 10.
Stand by,
Tiffany.
Stand by opening film, stand by music, stand by announce.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Cue the timpani.
I was the third brother of five, doing whatever I had to do to survive. I'm not saying what I did was all right. Trying to break out of the ghetto was a day-to-day fight. Being down so long, getting up didn't cross my mind. But I knew there was a better way of life, and I was just trying to find. You don't know what you do till you put under pressure. Cross 110th Street is a hell of a tester. Across 110th Street, pimps trying to catch a woman. Shooting that dope man, you're copping out.